Hello guys, and welcome back to another video of Architects 3DP. I'm finally back after a very long time. I've been very busy at work and so on, but now I'm gonna invest a lot of time making videos, guys. And very cool projects that were in standby are finally gonna be coming to the channel. So stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe to Architects 3DP. In this video, I'm going to test some PLA filament that was sent to me by Filoalfa, one of the best filament manufacturers in Europe. This video format is new in the channel, since some companies have been providing filament for my projects. I'm gonna start this open series where I will test different filaments from every interested company in the market. If you're a filament manufacturer and you want me to test your filaments here at Architects 3DP, just let me know through my email, architects3dp@gmail.com. In this case, I'm going to test filaments from Filoalfa, a company based in Italy. They reached out to me a while ago and sent me what they call an alpha box that I have right here, and I don't really know what filaments are inside, so I'm gonna open it to check what's inside. But before starting, be sure to click here in the subscribe button and to ring that bell to be notified when new cool stuff is uploaded. If you do it, you will help me create new content and growing the channel to reach more special viewers like you. Alright, so this is the box we got, and I'm gonna open it to see what filaments Filoalfa sent us. As you can see, we have got what looks like three 250 1.75mm filament spool boxes. I'm gonna take them out to have a better look. Alright, so here we have them. If we have a look at the tags, we can read that the first box contains a spool of Alfaplus Rosa Pastello, the next one Azzurro Pastello, and finally the last one Verde Pastello. The tags are obviously in Italian, but due to its similarity with Spanish, they are perfectly understandable for me. We are going to test their new pastel pink, blue, and green PLA filaments. Now I'm going to take them out of the boxes to have a better look to those nice colors. As you can see, they come vacuum packed inside plastic bags to preserve the properties of the material, which is great. Check it out, guys! These colors are stunning! I'm gonna take the filament spools out of the bags now using a cutter to see the filament colors in its own glory. I don't know if you can watch it on camera, but these colors look really great. Alright guys, so as you can see, this filament looks really great. But how do they perform? That's something that we're gonna test right now. For that, I'm gonna load them into my Architects 3DP i3 3D printer that we built in the channel a while ago. By the way, you should check out the build series where I explain how to build it step by step, clicking here in the top right corner or in the link in the description. Alright, so for the test, I'm gonna make 4 small and fast prints to show the best features of each material, and finally a cool big print with each of the 3 colors. For the small tests, we'll use the common Marvin, the 3D Benchy, and the 20mm Testcube, and then I'll print a crystal formation 3D model that shows very well the different tones and reflections of the material. Finally, for the big prints, I'm gonna print this Piggy Bank in pastel pink, this very detailed character in pastel green, and last but not least, this amazing frozen castle in pastel blue. You can find those 3D models in my mini factory website, but I will link them down in the description as well, so you can download them easier. Now yes, I've printed all the models I just explained, and these are the results we got. As you can see, these pastel tones are very beautiful. If we have a closer look, the quality in this print is just fantastic. I've used 3 walls, a 10% infill with the geroid pattern, 210 degrees for the nozzle, 45 degrees for the bed, a 95% flow, and a print speed of 40mm per second. As you can see, these pastel pink objects have a weird finished surface, and it was caused because I set by mistake the layer fan to 100%. When I noticed that was the problem, I reduced the speed to a 40% and the finished surface now just as beautiful as this.
Now yes, I'm gonna show you the big prints that you are waiting for. First, in pastel pink,
here we have this nice piggy bank that was printed in two parts, the body itself and the tab that goes here in the bottom. As you can see, the quality of this material is really good with the settings I mentioned before.
Jumping to the pastel blue,
here we have the frozen castle 3D model. It looks just fantastic, as you can see. Maybe I should have reduced the filament flow a little bit, but the quality is really good after all.
The print times were so wrong. 17, 18 and 20 hours at a 40mm per second print speed for each model.
But this time investment was worth it, because look at this result, guys.
Last but not least, we have this pastel green print.
I've used this filament to print out this very detailed character that looks just amazing in this pastel green tone. Since the filament is very clear, you can perfectly see all the details, and that was also thanks to the great job of our custom built 3D printer, the Architects 3DP i3, that I will link down below.
Alright, so that was it for this video, guys. Remember that you will find the links for the STL files down in the description. If you like this cool Alfaplus Pastello bundle, don't forget to check it out on filoalfa3d.com, where you can buy it for a very affordable price. If you're a filament manufacturer and you want me to test your filaments here at Architects 3DP, just let me know via email at architects3dp@gmail.com. Finally, I just wanted to ask you to subscribe to Architects 3DP if you still haven't. Hit the like button, leave a comment, and share this episode so more people will be able to enjoy with the new projects. And as always, a special shout out to my Patreon supporters for making this channel possible. If you want to join them and support the channel as well, you can do it navigating to patreon.com/architects3dp or clicking here in the top right corner. Okay guys, so as always, see you in the next video.